right, Dana, I got a question. You said coming into this, you knew what you were getting into with Nick Diaz, so not that anyone here blames you for making this move so soon, but couldn't you have seen this coming and perhaps sent somebody there to put him on the plane or something? You know, is this... You know?
Caesar Gracie had him in his house. Nick snuck out the back door.
Oh, jeez.
He snuck out the back door of Caesar's Gracie's house. So then Caesar's been looking for him all over town and his friends. I called Nate Diaz. I told Nate. Nate's like, yeah, I hear you. You know, it's just like, it's not like any of those guys were shocked or.
Right.
You know? So I was supposed to see this coming. Like, I mean, I knew we were going to have problems with Nick Diaz, but I mean, come on. I didn't expect this. If I knew this was going to happen, I would have never made the fight.
Right.
Why waste my time, money, energy, and embarrass everybody with this deal? You know, I got this guy flying all over the place, breaking camp to promote a fight that's not even happening now. You know, he flew from Montreal on Monday night, right? Goes down into Toronto, gets up the next day, does a full day of media, press all day, for a fight that's not even gonna happen now. You know, look at how much he's disrespected George St-Pierre and what he's done to him. It's just...
Do you feel disrespected?
Do I feel disrespected? Listen, I got thick skin. I get over shit quick. I'll live. I'll get over it. I like the Condit fight. I like the Carlos Condit fight. So I'd be a little pissed if I couldn't make another fight.
Right.
I might be a little more bummed out.
Danny.
First of all, this is Joe. Google me with ProMMANow.com with George St-Pierre at the 137 press conference. George, thanks for taking the time with us.
Thank you very much.
You've said a lot about Nick Diaz's championship spirit over the last couple days. Would you like to revise those statements, or how do you feel about him still as a fighter?
Now, Nick Diaz is a warrior, you know, and he said this. When he's in that fight, he's got a spirit of a warrior, but I would say he doesn't have the spirit for the commitment that it takes to the champion. You know, I don't know what happened. I'm just completely taken off guard by this news right now.
So you're just rolling with the punches, then?
Roll with the flow.
All right. You touched on it a little bit during the press conference, but I just want to ask you: there's mounting pressure on you, or I would think pressure, to finish these fights over these super tough opponents. Do you feel like you need to finish fights in the tail end of your career, or will you be happy if you dominate the way you have been over this tough competition?
I wanna finish the fight, but the competition is very hard in my division. The guys are very good, and I think I need to be more upwards on this, and I'm working on this right now.
And finally, it was announced yesterday that Josh Koscheck and Matt Hughes are gonna fight UFC 135. You face these guys a total of 5 combined times, so obviously your opinion is very valuable on the subject. Can you give us a prediction on who you think will come out on top from that?
I think Koscheck will win the fight. And, I don't think it's going to be a long night.
Okay. Thanks a lot, George. We appreciate the time. Thank you.